Okay, this video I'm getting back to work on the Pontiac. Done playing with it, riding around in it. I had to go up to Romeo yesterday to, I don't know if I show up in this or not, take my dad to his doctor's appointment to get his staples removed from his back surgery. He's doing pretty darn good. While I was up there, I went to an auto parts, the Auto Value Auto Parts that's Northern Washington Township there to see about paint. That's where I always bought my paint for the past cars I've done. And he came out with $300 for everything, including the reducers and the hardeners and whatnot. So they have the formulas to mix it in enamel. But the problem is he won't guarantee a match unless I bring them apart from the car. And then he said he'd mix me a pint of paint and I could spray something to make sure it matches, and if it does, he'll mix up a gallon. He's always done my paint in the past and always done a really good job, so I think I'll get the pint and paint the door jamb, mask it off here, and then when I get the door jamb painted, I can mask that off, and then I can paint this whole, that bottom of that front fender, the rocker panel, and the bottom of this quarter panel all in one shot. I can have the passenger side done. But before I can get the paint matched, I got to take them apart off the car. So I'm taking the gas filler door here. I can put a couple bolts up in there. I'm going to take that emblem off and I'm going to buff this out. He wants this buffed out like I'm going to do the rest of the car. So I'm going to buff the gas door out. I didn't want to buff anything or on the car. I don't know if you're not familiar with painting cars, you want to keep silicones, anything with silicones away. Don't even spray off or bug spray or anything near your car. I mean, you could spray it 100 yards away and if it drifts and gets on the car, you'll get little fish eyes everywhere where the silicones in that spray got on your finish. So it's really important to try and keep your finish oil and free of any sprays like that whatsoever, solvents, like rubbing compounds that have the stuff in them. That can all cause issues with your paint, car waxes, anything. That's why I was leaving the wheeling out the finish until the very last. Absolutely, this thing will be all the paint work will be done. It'll have tires on it. I'll have hopefully the seat repaired before I wheel out the paint. And the reason why is you don't want any of those silicones from anything on your body before you paint. And I'm going to paint this with acrylic enamel, and that really needs to cure for about 30 days before you hit it with a buffer, because I'm going to mask off probably on this body line right here. So I'm only going to paint from here down on the fender, and I'll probably just overspray this. I'll sand this out, sand the paint out here so the paint adheres, but I'm not going to sand it to the metal, and then I'll just let this overspray kind of up in here, and then I'll take some 600, maybe some 1200, and give it a light sanding out, and then I'll hit it with the buffer, and you shouldn't see the paint line whatsoever. There's a scratch. I'll touch the couple. There's a couple scratches in the car. I'll touch them up with my touch-up brush, and but I'll just use my little door jam gun. And if I get a pint mixed up and paint this door jam, I still got to put the body seam sealer up there in the front, like GM did. I'll do that today so it can cure, because maybe tomorrow or Friday I might run up there and see about getting the pint mixed, and then I'll spray it over the weekend if the weather and everything cooperates and I have the time. And if it's a good match, I'll have them mix up a gallon so I can get started on the painting of the body. And a gallon should paint all the areas I plan on painting plus the trunk pan. So I should be able to get the trunk pan in body color too. So I just got back from my physical at the doctor's, and that was awesome. My cholesterol was right where it should be. My blood sugar, everything, she said, was exactly right, spot on good. My blood pressure the works. So I was really pleased with that. I do have a little extra on my belly here, my taters. I've been working on losing that. A while back I lost 80 pounds in 3 months, and I put it back on, 60 pounds back on. I took it off too quick. So this, I'm down about 25 pounds in 3 months now, and I'm going to try and lose another 25 pounds, and then hopefully I'll feel better. I tell you what, it's okay. Put it in perspective. A car battery probably weighs, I'm guessing, about 25 pounds. And so take a couple car batteries and strap it to your gut and walk around, sleep, do everything with those car batteries strapped to you, and you'll know what it's like if you're not overweight like I've been, to carry that extra weight. So when I lost 25 pounds, that's like not carrying an extra car battery. So when I go up and down stairs, it's like leaving a car battery behind, not carrying one up and down stairs with me. So I feel a lot better just from 25 pounds. So hopefully another 25 and I'll feel any better, or feel a lot better. But anyway, back to the car. So I'm gonna buff out that panel. I burned out my last buffer, so I just went and got a new one. It's Sears, and it's got a foam pad. And what's nice, when you buff paint, you want to do it at a lower RPM. This isn't an orbital waxer. When you buff, you don't use orbital, but this has got variable speeds. So when you turn it on, you can slow it down, speed it up. Probably buffing with this old paint and this buffer, I'll probably run the buffer maybe around that, probably right around that speed there. I hope the current on the buffer didn't drown out the sound on the camera, but I'm going to do it at a lower speed. And the compounds I use, I couldn't find my, I have a, buy this 3M buffing compound by the gallon, and I just put it in one of these to make it easier to squirt it out. So this is kind of a coarse buffing compound you use to get your heavy oxidization scratches and marks out of the paint, the 3M stuff. And if I find the gallon, I'll put a little video of it too. I don't know where it went. This is almost full. So, and then I usually go over it with a fine cleaner. This brings the luster out a little bit better. It's like going from if you sand it with a 600 and then you go to this might be like a 3000 grit, and maybe this would be like, just pulling numbers out of thin air, this might be like a 5000 grit. So you get a lot finer shine with this. And then I'll go with a wax. I did drop this one on the ground and kind of made a mess, and I did use some colorful language. When that hit the ground, it made a heck of a mess. So that's all cleaned up, and there's still some in there. This is the swirl remover. It's what that would have been in this bottle had I not used this bottle for the 3M. When this bottle went empty, that's why I magic markered on it. It's the 3M, so I'd have this little top that I could squirt it out of. But this is what that would have been. And they just kind of, the finer you go, the more shine you get. And then when you're all done, then you go to your car waxes. And this is the what I've been using to like wax the truck. And this will work good on things like that too. So I'm gonna try and get that buffed out today, get the gas door off, maybe tomorrow or Friday, run back up to Romeo, to the Auto Value Auto Parts there where I always went in the past for paint. They're really good with paint. And get a pint mixed up, and then I'll spray the jam this weekend again and get a gallon of paint mixed up. So that's just kind of what's going on with the Pontiac right now, and I'll get this thing wheeled out and maybe do a little video of it wheeled out. Well, I just popped off the emblem. I got to clean a little bit of that dirt up. The emblem is in surprisingly good shape. I hit it with some chrome polish. It'll probably look like brand new. yeah, it just held on with a couple of those steel type nuts. Well, look at that. This is a Michigan car, remember? So that thing's in nice shape for the age of the car. 57-year-old car. I wanted to add this little interesting little gadget to this video. My dad's girlfriend, his partner in life that he has since my mom passed away, somebody owned a service station in Sheboygan, Michigan, and they use this to clean the windshields on the cars. So I fill this with windshield washer fluid, this top unscrews, and then there's like a tire valve here. So you just charge it with compressed air there, and it pressurizes it, and then you can, I don't know if this will show up or not, but you push this little thumb thing here, and it shoots out a stream of windshield washer fluid. I absolutely love this little thing. If anyone knows anything about these, I think it originally might have had a rubber base on it, so you know when you set it on something it didn't scratch it, and I think this held from a belt loop and the attendant, gas station attendant. And remember, you know, this is an era from when you pulled into a gas station, an attendant would come rushing out, would put gas in your car, clean your windows, check your oil, hopefully not slice your belt with a razor blade until you need a new fan belt, but you know, they would check the air in your tires and your oil level in the crankcase, your water in your radiator, they'd clean your windows, and this is what they would use to clean the windows, squirt on the, you can kind of, there. And then you just wipe it off. I was going to use that to clean the back dirt off the gas door. But that kind of gives you an idea what you do to how it works. So if anyone knows anything about these, I've never seen one of these in my life before, and I just really, really, really like it. And so we'll get this cleaned up and get the buffer out and get the buffer going on it. It looks, yeah, it definitely did fade a little bit. It looks like there's a little lighter color. I don't know if that shows up in the video or not, because the guy that does the paint up there, Romeo Motor Parts, said that it will be faded and the factory mix will not match. And he said that's why he wanted the gas door and wanted it buffed out the way I want it on the car. So we'll get that puppy buffed out, and hopefully it'll be good enough for him to get a paint sample off of to mix the paint up for the car. So that's just a little bit about what's going on. I'll get a little video of that after I get it buffed out, but I like this little cap on the top. I think she said it was now don't quote me, because I don't know what that style of cap's from, but I think she said it was a standard gas station there in Sheboygan. And that was back before the Mackinac Bridge was there, and you'd take the old U.S. highways up, and then you'd wait for the car ferries and to take you across the Upper Peninsula, and I think her gas station wasn't too far from, or the gas station wasn't too far away to where people waiting, you know, would could get their windows cleaned, their brakes adjusted. And you got to remember, this cars of this era didn't have self-adjusting brakes, so you'd have to periodically take your brake spoon and go around and adjust the brakes on it. I still do that on my 59 Chevy. I still adjust the brakes, oh, for what little I drive it, about once every 2 or 3 years. And but if you drive them, you know, 10, 12,000 miles a year, you might have to do them once a year. So this is a little bit about some interesting old memorabilia that I have. And I also, as I like this kind of stuff, I have this old, that too. And interesting list of things that you can use the soil on the back of a can for. So, yeah, that's just some of the little nickel and dime stuff I like to collect. Well, I went to use my 3M in the bottle and it was like a brick. So I went and found my compound. So if anyone wants to know what it is, this is what I use. So if you have a paint job that really is oxidized or heavy scratches or just really needs a good thorough wheeling out, this stuff does the job. It says it has no silicones in it. Basically, it's a mild abrasive. And if you want to read this, just pause it if it's in focus. So that kind of tells you a little bit about it. So that's the rubbing compound I'll use for the coarse rubbing. Well, I'm not going to do this with the camera going, but I'm going to kind of give you an idea how I do it. What I usually do with the, if the squirt bottle wasn't rock hard, what I would do is just take a little bit and put a little on the body, and then you work it one way and then the other way a little bit, and you do it until it's kind of hazy clean. And what I'm going to do, because my squirt bottle, you do it a couple different ways. I never put it on the pad because it just flicks everywhere. So I'm going to use a brush, and I'll brush some on the gas door, and then I'll just hit it with that, and hopefully it'll come out. But you got to be careful. This is not an orbital, so you can burn your paint real easy with these. So you got to be really careful when you're using a machine like this. You don't burn the paint. Orbital machines generally don't burn the paint. Usually what I do, the waxing with an orbital one, get it out yet, orbital machine, but for really buffing out the heavy oxidization and paint issues like this, I'll buff this out. That'll probably give a light little sand. Hit it with some 600 or 1200 and that should buff out. I think I had some type of solvent or something on my sleeve when I was leaning over the car working on the engine, and it kind of messed up the surface of the paint there. I was pretty disgusted about it, but I think it'll buff out. So hopefully it buffs out. But anyway, we're going to get the gas door done. All right. That's some of the 3M compound, and it's kind of a syrupy consistency. So I'll just slap a little on this brush. Go slop it on that gas door and hit it with the machine. So just wanted to kind of show you the really good compounds are kind of syrupy. The ones like, whoops, well, I just dumped more out. Thank God I have paper towel there. But that's a much thinner, and I'll just drain that back into the bottle so I can use it until I find another bottle. But I just wanted to show the consistency of the compounds. Well, I poured it back in there, no big mess. Just left it in the garbage can here so I can use a little bit of that when I'm done with the course. I'll use a little bit of what's left on the paper towel on the back. So, get to it. Well, I don't know if the camera is going to do that justice or not, but that paint put some, I don't know if that even will do it justice. That paint shined up like glass. It's as shiny as my pickup. It really, this car is going to look amazing once it's wheeled out. I just don't think the camera can do that justice. That literally looks like a brand new paint job. That wheeled out so nice. If the rest of the car wheels out as nice as that gas door, wow. And that just was off the gas door alone. So this car is going to look amazing if the rest of it shines up like that. Well, I wanted to add one last little bit to this video. Everything came out pretty good. I got it 320. There's no little sanding marks or anything in there. There is one little nick right there, and I'll just use this. I don't like using this stuff. It's just basically a thick primer. So they call it spot putty. So I might just hit that one little spot there, a little spot putty, let it dry 24 hours, you sand it out. This is a filler primer, so sanding this out will fill any little scratches and nicks. But the spot putty is if you have something like that little, I don't know if you can see that or not, but that little mark, this will fill that, and then you just sand it out when you sand your primer out. And like I say, this, see, I've used very little of it over the years. I just don't particularly, if you do the job right, you shouldn't need this stuff. But occasionally you do need it, so I do keep it on hand. Well, I got the gas store off take to the paint store, but I think there's a little something here I don't think you'd read about. This car, I'm going to try and hold the camera and show it at the same time. These are the screws that held the gas door on. So they look like 5/16 inch screw heads. So I got my 5/16 socket out, but I couldn't loosen it up because the socket just rotated around the screw head and the next size smaller wouldn't fit over it. So I got my 8mm socket out and it fits it perfect. Unscrewed it, no slop, nothing. So, I mean, this is a 57-year-old car. I wouldn't have thought they would have used a metric screw head in 1960. Unless somebody's taken this off, and it doesn't appear to have ever been off the car. This never appears to have been removed. But that definitely fits the 8mm and does not fit the 5/16, just slips around it. I just thought that was kind of interesting. I don't think anyone would read about that. Anyway, thank you for watching my videos.